Hi everyone, I'm Mano Marks. This is Susanna Robb and Marcelo Cameo. We're on the Google Maps API team. Marcelo and Susanna have kindly agreed to join us from the Sydney office. They're here for Google I/O, and they'll be talking to you in just a moment about their sessions at Google I/O. Susanna is the tech lead for the Google Maps API, and Marcelo is the tech lead for the Google Places API. So we're really excited to have them here. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Maps API developer relations team. So, hi, welcome guys.
Thanks, Matt.
Thank you,
Matt. Thanks for joining us. So the first thing I want to do is ask each of you to give us a little summary of what you're going to be talking about in your sessions. So let's start with you, Susanna.
Sure. My talk next week is called Maps API Best Practices, and along with my teammate Jez, we will be talking about sort of common traps people fall into in using the Maps API, as well as some things you can do to make your map a little bit better, and then some things to make your map really awesome. So going through some old features and new features that will really make a good map great.
Can you give any hints on things that you're going to be talking about specifically?
I think so. We'll be showing some demos that use a combination of our many services and features, and I think some of those show some compelling uses of the Maps API that perhaps some developers haven't thought of to use before.
Okay, great. And Marcelo, do you want to?
Yeah. So the name of our talk is Building a Business Around the Place API. Mm-hmm. So we'll be giving an overview of what the Place API is. We also want to go into some basic principles that we think developers should keep in mind when building an application using the Place API, and also when they're aiming to actually turn that into a business.
Great, great, sounds great. I'm also going to be giving a talk, but on enterprise uses of Google Maps API, but you're here to talk to Susanna and Marcelo today. So just a reminder, all the content that is, all the sessions that are at Google I/O will be recorded. And so you'll get a chance, even if you don't get to go to Google I/O, you'll get a chance to see all that content. So I wanted to ask each of you, I ask everybody this, so, you know, please forgive me, but what are your favorite Maps API sites? So Susanna, let's start with you. And I'd asked them previously, so we have this loaded up.
My favorite changes from time to time, but right now, I thought this one was pretty cool that I just saw. So this is in time for the London Olympics. It's a site that the BBC has done called London Calling. And some things
Let me get this on screen share here for the Hangout. Sorry, I just realized that. I need to do that. Here we go.
So some of the things I like about this site, first, fairly simple. I like that they have customized their use of the controls. So instead of having all of our default controls showing all the time, they just have the zoom control, and they've set the min and max zoom so that you just are seeing London, and it does not encourage you to go look at the rest of the world. They also are using styled maps so that you get the features of London without having the map actually be the main focus here. The map is sort of the backdrop for the content that they've put on top of it. So then when you click on these circles, these areas of London, you get some features within them. Mano, if you can close this sort of up at the top there. Okay, and if you click on a marker, here's where it gets kind of cool. They have this sort of info window that comes up on top with a cutout showing the marker in the middle, and you can use the arrows to click back and forth.
Oh, that's very cool. Yeah.
It's pretty cool. I think this really shows well creative ways to display data on top of the map. And I love the use of the styled maps, really.
That is pretty awesome.
To convey this.
Yeah. Marcelo, you had a couple?
Oh, yeah. So one of them is SkyV. I think that's how we pronounce it, which is an app that does voice commands. And you can do pizza near me or closest Starbucks, and works really well, mm-hmm. really well, and uses the Place API for all its local results.
That's on Android, right?
That's on Android, yeah. And then another one is WhatsApp, which is a really popular messaging app, and it's cross-platform, and allows you to, when you send a message, you can tag the message with the location and uses the Place API to allow you to do a snap to place.
Cool. All right, let's turn off off screen share. Those are some great applications. So anything you're excited about Google I/O? Anything you're particularly looking forward to?
Oh, I always enjoy just going to Google I/O. I like, I think my favorite thing is actually getting a chance to meet developers face to face. Marcelo and I don't get to do that very often. We just, you know, read comments on the web. So I think that's my favorite part. Usually the fireside chat, hearing people's questions and compliments and rants, all of them.
Yeah, that's a good.
Yeah, it's definitely the highlight of my year. I've been actually present to all Google I/O so far, never missed one, and don't want to miss this one. I've actually went through to the schedule, and I've signed up for, I've chosen 16 sessions to attend. Yeah, so it's going to be pretty intense, and really looking forward to it.
Cool. All right. I think it might be time to take some questions. So why don't we see if there's any questions from the Hangout? Anybody in the Hangout have some questions? If you have a question, I can't actually see anybody on the Hangout. Can you sort of raise your hand if you want to ask a question? I'm not seeing anyone. Okay, so it looks like we don't have any questions from the Hangout. So maybe if we can mute all those folks. And then I'll just take a look at the moderator, where we have a few questions here that people submitted beforehand. So the first question, how can I write tests against my web application that uses the Google Maps API? Do you have any mocks available you could share similar to your externs?
So we don't currently have any mocks. You can certainly use mocking frameworks to and use the externs. First of all, I will definitely encourage you to write tests, and I'm glad somebody has asked this question. I think this is this is something we want to encourage, and so it's really nice to see developers coming to us and asking for us this before we even have to tell you should be doing this. So you can use some, you can mock classes using the externs that are available today. We don't have any separate mocks available, but most testing frameworks should have a mocking system. And the externs will work to do that.
Cool. So the next question is, will Google be releasing a native iOS app now that MapKit in iOS 6 is changing to use Apple's Maps? We don't tend to talk about things we're going to be doing before we do them, so we can't really comment on what our future plans are. We're, of course, always interested in mobile platforms, particularly Android and iOS. So we can't tell you what our future plans are at this point. But thanks for asking that. That's the same question as before. So the next question is, any idea when we'll start to see a Google Maps API that lets us build real HTML5 experiences? I think this is getting at basically when will we see the Maps GL experiment that's currently running on maps.google.com available in the API.
We can't comment on exact plans here. It is something that we're interested in. We still see issues around browsers being able to support WebGL to the extent that we need them to in order to run the API across the web using WebGL. Certainly something to watch for in the future. No concrete plans for you to announce.
And for those of you who don't know more about this experiment, basically maps.google.com is running a experiment that uses vector rendering in WebGL instead of map tiles for all the maps data. And it's a really exciting and slick experience if you have, you know, Chrome or Safari or Firefox, one of the browsers that support WebGL, and a pretty nice graphics card. So you may notice your fan spinning up really fast. We've also been doing a number of different tests and demo apps using WebGL to display on top of Google Google Maps. So, for instance, some stuff that Chris Broadfoot and I talked about at Strata, and also Brendan Kenny and I are going to be doing a code lab at Google I/O, talking about using different aspects of HTML5 with your mapping experience. So. Have a look out for those resources. Okay, so then next question is there a way to use Weather Layer as a Google Maps service to find nearest markers forecast, something like Get Panorama by Location and Street View service?
No, the Weather Layer is purely a layer on top of the map. I think what you're asking for is a weather service. Go ahead and file a feature request for that. No promises, but we'd love to see feature requests for such things.
And by the way, we have an issue tracker. Just search for GMAPS API issues, and that's where you can file feature requests and bugs as well. And next question, can a marker be more than just an image without having to write your own custom overlay?
No, a marker is just an image. There are some libraries that do this for you. So our developer relations team, Luke and Chris, wrote a few different marker applications. One is an HTML marker. So this does all the wrapping of the custom overlay for you. And I believe it is still draggable. So you can use that library. There's also one, they have a label marker, which puts text with markers. And but otherwise, if you want to have custom DOM elements and a custom look, you do need to write a custom overlay.
And those libraries are in the Google Maps API utility library, which is linked off our documentation, or you can just search for it. Make sure you're looking at the V3, not the V2 utility library. Question about how to get in touch with a Google Maps for Business sales rep. If you're having trouble, just ping me off on, just share a post with your contact info with me on Google Plus, and I'll forward that on to the sales folks. What are some best practices for implementing an existing V3 map into a Drupal 7 environment? I have no idea. Not a Drupal person at all, so no clue. No Drupal folks on the. Sorry about that. I'm sure there are Drupal communities who would be happy to help out with this. And the last question I can't really make out. It says, "What is the best way to get volume on a website?" And the username is Evil Troll, so I'm just going to leave it at that. So, wow, okay. Looks like the Hangout had some weird screen sharing going on. Okay, so any questions from the Hangout? If anybody have a question, just raise your hand and we'll see if we can answer it. Okay. No questions. So I think we'll go ahead and wrap it up then. So thank you guys for coming in, and thanks for joining us for the office hours, everyone.